Everyone, today I'm here because I have something very exciting to share with you guys. So a lot of you guys already know Wild Orchid Crafts, and they sell a whole bunch of craft supplies, and their main thing is flower, but that's not the only thing they sell. They sell a whole lot of other things as well. So right now they're having a design team call, and I am really excited about this because I have always been a big fan of their products, and this is just something I would absolutely love to do. I would love to design for them. And I do use their product on a lot of my projects. I just think that it finishes it off beautifully. It's just the perfect accent. So the entries are supposed to be one video only per person, but you are allowed to show more than one project. And what I wanted to do is I actually wanted to show a little bit of variety. We were asked to show a project that best demonstrates our style. And if you guys follow my channel, you will know that I do a lot of varieties. I do a lot of different things. I don't have one set style. I like to do different things. It all depends on my mood. It depends on what the project is and what it is for. So I've got three things here. I've got a couple of cards over there. I've got a gift bag, and I also have this super duper cute money box that I have created. And I've been working on these projects for a couple of weeks now, and you will see this one was the most time consuming. It took me a long time to finish it off and everything. And what I'll do, I'll just reposition the camera now, and I will share with you guys in detail each different project. So I'll be right back. Okay, so the first projects that I wanted to share with you guys are these cards. And as you can see, the cards are very, very similar. I have followed the same steps for both cards, and the only thing that changes is the images that I have used and a couple of variety in the color of the flowers, but that's about it. So I'm just going to run through one of the cards because of course the other card is going to be the same. So I'll put this one aside. This little image here is actually a La La Land stamp. I have only just started learning to do coloring, so of course the coloring is not going to be perfect. But I did do some paper piecing with her dress and these little hearts right here. If you look close enough, that's what they look like there. And everything else I've actually colored with my Pro markers. Now, this card is actually an easel card. So this is how it works right here. And it stands out like this. And this is what it looks like on the side here. So the inside has a sort of follow through with the theme, and this is where I would write my message. And I have got like a bow and some pearls going on here. And the front of the card, the paper is actually from the Tea Party collection by Dovecraft. These little banners or buntings here are also from the same collection, and again the papers I've used here. I've used the doily on the background here, and then I matted the image onto some cardstock matching the colors. And now the fun part is of course the Wild Orchid Craft products. So here I have used some seam binding, and this one was actually the Cameo Beige. Here I have used some Cherry Blossom, and by the way, a lot of the things that I have used I already had in my stash. So what I'll be doing is the items that I have the code here next to me, I will share right now on the video. And for the other items that I don't have the code, I will actually add to the description box below. So I will have the code for every single product that I have used in the description below so that you guys can go and check it out on the Wild Orchid Craft website. So here is some Cherry Blossom, and this is the green pack. Right here I have some carnations, and the carnation actually came from this pack right here, and that's the code. I have also used this tiny little gardenia here, which I absolutely love. It looks like that, and this one came from this pack, and there's a variety of colors pack, and this is the code right here. And I love this pack. It actually has loads of different colors in it. And then here I have got another tiny little rose, and I'll have the code below. Right here below I have a ribbon rose. And then right here in the center of the seam binding, I have seen a lot of people do this with these products, and they're actually from Wild Orchid Crafts as well. And what they are actually ribbon buckles. And I have this pack of the silver and also this pack of the pearl, and right here is the code. And basically you just put one inside the other and add a little pearl to the center. And then right here I have these cute little flowers. I had them for a long time. I will have the code down below as well. And then I just added some pink stamens here, which are also from Wild Orchid Craft, of course. And this tiny little rose in the center. And I think the card turned out really cute. I added some pearls here just to accent. And that's the card completed. And of course the other card is exactly the same, except I think the little flower here is a slightly different color of green. So yeah, that's the cards that I've made for my entry. Now, second project that I wanted to share is this bag right here. And this was actually just a plain bag that looked like this. And it's just a paper bag. And I have just added some cardstock to the background here. I've stamped and distressed the paper. And then I have also added this beautiful vintage image right here in the center. And on the back I actually just added this. And this is the exact same thing as I did to the front, except I added this on top. So you can see here the background, what it looks like. And I distressed everything around. And then on the top I added this trim here. I think they're called Chinese braid. And this is from my stash. And then on top here I have this super cute little rose, and this one is this one right here, and that's the code. And I absolutely love these, they're so adorable. It's just such a cute little flower. I just love those little flowers. And then right here I have another one of those small roses, and this is the green pack. And again, I'll have all of the codes down below so you can go and check it out. And here is just the green cherry blossom. Right here is a brown rose, and it's a smaller one again to this one. And then here I've just added this butterfly charm, which is super cute, and it comes in the pack like this. And this is the code right here, and you have different metal embellishments. It's super fun. It has a variety of things in there. I just thought this butterfly would look really cute there. And I have also added a couple of pearls and beads there. Underneath I have this skeleton leaf, which is so fun to work with. I added two there. And then moving on here to the bottom part, I've added this beautiful eyelet lace here, or eyelet trim, and this is what it looks like here. And it's a very light tone of pink, and I added just on the button here. And then I added this beautiful lace here just above the rim. And then here is just this really super cute lace that Wild Orchid Craft sells. And I actually have a pack here. I need to restock, I'm out of it. And as you can see here, it's called White Cotton Lace, and this is the code right here. And it's called White Cotton because it was, of course, white. And I actually just dyed it with some ink because I wanted it to be a brown tone. So that's what it looks like there, and it looks so cute. And then I added this pearl here, and it's just like a rice-shaped pearl. And then here I have got one of my favorite flowers from Wild Orchid Craft, which is the gardenia. And this is the brown one, and I absolutely love these flowers. Well, I love all of them, as you can see. I use a lot of them on my projects, but this is one of my favorites. And then this one and this one right here, they are rosebuds. And I actually have the product right here, and it comes in a pack of 10, and this is what they're called, and that's the code. and they are so super cute. They're adorable. I love these. And then in between, I actually have some more of those super cute flowers that I showed you earlier, the one that is white and pink. And then down here I have got a small gardenia, which is from the pack that I showed you, this one right here. And here's the code again, just in case. And then I have got these super cute roses here, which I'll have the link below. And this is the same rose but in brown. And then a tiny little green one here. And then I have actually added some pearls here just to add a little bit of an accent. And I have a tiny little ribbon rose just there. And that finishes off the bag. Oh, actually, I'm forgetting here the cameo. Wild Orchid Craft sells these cameos, and they're actually, they have them in two different sizes. I'll have the link below as well. So what I did to this one, this is the small one, and I added a little bit of pearls to the outside. And then I've used one of Wild Orchid Craft's pin here as well. And I just glued the cameo to the pin, and that's what it looks like there. And then here I have some more skeleton leaves, and these ones are actually larger than the ones I've used up here. So that's what it looks like there. And that's the bag finished. So that's my second project. And now my third one, which is actually the biggest and the longest time that it took me. So of course, as you can see here, it's a little house. When I decided to make this, I decided that I was going to make a craft fund cottage money box. So this is what it is. And this, what you're looking at here, is the roof. So actually, let me start from the front here. So this is the front of the cottage. I hope the camera's gonna show the whole thing here. And the papers I've used for this one is the Prima Romantique collection. I absolutely love that collection, it's gorgeous. So I have made the little house out of cardboard. So I recycled an old box that I had, and I made the shape of the little box. And I actually made it so that it has a drawer here, which is how you take the money out. So you put the money through here, this little hole, and then when you're ready to buy your crafts, you just collect the money from here. So I'll start off from the front. So right here I've used one of Tim Holtz's number plaques, and this is really cute, and I thought it would look really nice in the little house. And then here I've used some more of that Chinese braid, and it's the same one as I've shared on a gift bag. And then this lace right here is again the Wild Orchid Craft cotton lace, which is this one. It was white, and I have also dyed this one a brown tone, and it looks super cute, and I just thought it would accent this roof really nicely. Down here I have two metal embellishments, and this is from the Wild Orchid Craft pack, this one right here. And let me just share with you guys something really fun. Actually, if you look at these bits right here, I have four of these left, and they actually didn't come like this. If you look here, I have a flower embellishment on the back, and the one that I have on the top here was actually a square looking charm. It had these bits here on the sides here. I can't really do this because I'm doing this backwards. But anyway, what I did, I actually trimmed that with my scissors, because this is actually quite thin metal. So you can actually trim that to fit your project however you want. And I thought that was quite cool. And then what I did, I actually added this pearl here, and then this dangly charm, which was actually a charm that I had in my stash already. And it has this big bubble here, which is really fun. And to the drawer, I didn't do very much because I was going to be handling this a lot. So I didn't want to glue flowers and they would end up, I don't know, breaking or coming off. And I didn't want to do that. But what I did do is I've used this polka dot paper, which was just the polka dot. And I did some fussy cutting from other papers from the same collection. So this one is just this cute little image here. And then I also done the same on the top here with the roses. And I just glued that there just to add a little bit more interest. So that's the draw. And I'll actually turn around to this side first. As you can see here, I've done the same thing. I've used a different paper for the background, which is from the same collection. And then I've done some fussy cutting here from another paper, which is this super cute image of these two little girls on the tree. I love it. And then I've done the same thing here on the bottom, these little flowers, and they look so pretty. Now here, these little metal charms here that I have, you can see here they're white and gold, and I have one on this corner and one on this corner right here. And basically what they are, let me put this down here. This is what they look like here. They're just metal corners, and they're from Wild Orchid Craft as well. I'll have the code down below for these as well. And you can see they're silver, but what I actually done, I've used some acrylic paint in white, painted them, and then I actually just added a little bit of accent with a gold paint. So again, you can just transform them however you want to match your project. So that adds a really nice accent. And then I just have this little window here that I've made out of cardboard, painted it and distressed with ink so that it looks, you know, fitting with the project. Now here at the back, again, as the front with the draw, I actually kept it very simple. So this was the paper I used for the back. And I just did some fussy cutting from a different paper with this lady here with loads of roses. As you guys know, I absolutely love roses, so anything that has roses on it, I love it. So this is what it looks like here. And before I go back to this side, I just want to explain what I did here on the roof. So because it's a cottage, of course, I wanted it to have a cottage-looking roof. And I don't know if you guys can make out here, but it's just a lace roof. And what I did, I actually cut out flowers from lace using my tattered floral die cut by Tim Holtz. And then I just used them to create the roof. And that's what it looks like right there. And I have two colors, of course. I have a slightly darker brown and the creamy kind of color just alternating. I just thought it would look fun. And I did that on both sides. And then right here on the top, I have this beautiful brown lace. And on top of that, I've used some more of that Wild Orchid Craft white cotton lace, which adds so much to the top here. It just looks so pretty. And then some more of the Chinese braid trim. So that makes out the roof. And now my favorite part, which is the front, because of course I'm not going to have it facing this way, I'm going to have it facing this way. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to go all out, because this is the side everybody's going to see, so I wanted to add some beautiful flowers. So let's get started then. So I'll start off by telling you that this window right here, I've added a little bit of lace so that it looks like the curtains inside the cottage. And then right here I started off with a pink gardenia, and then these are the trellis roses, which is another one of my favorites. I just absolutely love them. So I have some in pink here, which is from the same pack, and then the green is from, of course, the green pack, and then I've got the blue one as well here, which I actually have the code for the blue one here. I don't have for the others because they were already from my stash. But this is the code here for the blue pack. And I'll have the code for the others down below once again. So then here, I have got a cherry blossom here, another trellis rose here. These two, the green ones, are from the same pack. And then here I have another small gardenia. The yellow one and the blue one came from this pack right here. Again, the one that I shared with you earlier. And then I have also added the carnation flower again, and that's the pack right there. And then down here I've got another one of the cherry blossom. This is a green one. So here on the top I have these crystals, and these are also from Wild Orchid Craft, and again I'll have the code on the description below. And then here I just added some pearls, and I just added them to a wire just so it's easier to glue here. And here's some more of those crystals here. I added some of these pearls on the back here because I wanted to add some interest here to the back. And then here I've just made this pretty little bow here with seam binding. And the color I used for that one was the camel hair, or camel's hair. Okay, and then here in the center I just added this beautiful piece of jewelry here. It was part of a necklace that I had and I just added to the center. I just thought it looked really pretty there. And then here on the other side I have another one of those cute little roses. The white and pink roses, and they're just so adorable. I love them. Can you tell? And then here is another carnation, and this is again from the pink pack. And then here another green cherry blossom, and here just another one of the trellis rose, and this is the blue one. Another small gardenia here in pink, and another cherry blossom right here on the corner. And then right here, I added these super adorable little flowers. They're also Wild Orchid Craft. And I'll have the code below. This was part of my stash, so I don't remember the code. And then here, I've got another one of Wild Orchid Craft pins. And this is the crown pin, and I absolutely love them. They just look beautiful. And I added this pretty little pearl here with this nice little acrylic flower. And then one of these rhinestone spacers and another blue pearl here. And I think I covered everything. I just added a little bit of pearls here to accent as well, and some ribbon roses. And I think that's it. And let me just show you the inside of this. This is what it looks like inside. I have actually decorated the inside as well. It's not perfect, but it doesn't need to be because nobody's gonna look in there. And that's it really. So this is what the drawer looks like here. It's just covered in paper. And I've got the polka dot, same as the front, to the back. And that's it really. Let me just move these out of the way here. So here are my three project entries. I really hope you guys like my project. If you have any questions, please comment below and let me know. I'll be more than happy to answer. And I really can't wait to see everybody else's project. So everybody who's entering, I wish you the best of luck. And yeah, I just can't wait to hear some results. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and like my projects. I would love to hear some feedback. So if you guys could please comment below and just let me know what you think. I would love to hear that. So thanks everybody for watching. I will see you next time. Bye.